So today I want to talk about, as far as, you know, a lot of people sign up for my OnlyFans. I'm giving a lot of game on my OnlyFans. What I'm going to do, I'm going to create another site where I'm getting a little bit more deeper in detail in my game that I'm giving, because OnlyFans really kind of allows you to do so much. So I'm working on a site right now that's going to switch over from OnlyFans, and you'll be able to have more access to my guides, more ways to break down on how to learn things that you need to learn. I'm finna get ready to come out with that. I definitely have letters for sale on my OnlyFans, right? But a lot of people don't know exactly how to use the letters. They get lost. They don't know how to, what sites to go on to basically put the letters through. They don't know how to mail the letters out. They don't know anything about, you know, attorney letters and 609 letters and stuff like that. So I'm giving step by step. It's like a 35, 45 minute video on how to do clean anything off anybody's credit and your credit, inquiries, everything. There's nothing left out on. So I know people gonna hate me for it, just like every time I give y'all sauce, people hate when I tell y'all the game on this or that, because they feel like, man, he give me all the, people do not want you to win in life. Understand how life works. They do not want you to win. So they be mad at people like me for giving you the game on the primary, trade lines, credit cleaning, because they rather you spend your money into them, right? So that you can pay them and keep needing them. This is the crazy thing about life, right? So with credit, you're always going to get an inquiry on your credit, right? You're always going to get an inquiry on your credit. Understand this. So why would I want to keep giving somebody my information when I can just clean it off anytime it pops on my credit myself? If a bill or child support or repo pop on your credit, you want to be able to remove it yourself without always having to call somebody. If anything pops up on your credit as far as a bill, anything, right? You can take it off yourself without actually always needing somebody to clear it off. What comes with somebody clearing your credit off? Your information, social ID, because in order to clean credit, they actually will need your social security card or a photo of it or a picture of your ID. So why would you want to be giving random people all this information so that they can hit a lick on you later? You know what I'm saying? So I teach on my OnlyFans, you should clean your own credit. You should add your own primaries. You should add your own trade lines. Yes, people hate it. People hate it to the core who do what I do, because they feel like I'm messing up their money, right? Because I'm giving y'all game on how to do this yourself. People don't really worry about credit until they're older. I'd be so happy when I see a 19, 18, 20-year-old hitting me up about credit, because people at that age do not worry about credit. But I'm glad that I can come and show people that, man, listen, get your credit fixed early so when you get older, you have the best credit score. I want y'all to do this test for me. This is a challenge. Ask a lot of older people about, do they know about primary? Like, do you know what a primary is? Or do you know what a trade line is? And see what they say. And I can bet you 75% of people do not know what it is, right? So 75% of people don't even know that they can take whatever off their credit. Now, somebody hit me up on OnlyFans. They was like, oh, well, you know, I'm in a check system and this and that. I'm gonna let you know. Whatever is in your name, even if you have something negative on your record, like you might have a background, right? Do you know you can get it took off? You can get it expunged. You can actually hit a lawyer up and actually pay to get whatever's on your background. If it ain't too crazy, remove, right? So if you're in a check system, there's letters out here that you can get to clean your credit, how to remove yourself out the check system, how to get your record clean and build your credit. That's the main things of the key of life. Even if somebody got cash, one thing that you're going to run into, they're going to be like, man, I got all this money, man. I can't do nothing with it. Why? Because this world evolves around taxes. This world evolves around banks, right? So let me tell you one of the biggest scams about banks. Banks, let's say if you got $200,000 in your account. Do you know a bank will hold your money and actually borrow your money out that you worked real hard for and only give you a little percentage off for letting them hold it? When you can just hold it yourself, because if, like I said in the last video, if the electricity went out right now, you will lose access to Bitcoin, you'll lose access to these banks, ATMs, all that would not work. So it's better. That's why you see very wealthy people, when they get real rich, they might have money in the banks, but they have a couple million dollars in a safe as well. So why? Because if something do happen in the world, only thing somebody is gonna sell from you is cash money, right? Because ain't no banks open in there. You gotta remember, the regular person who works at the bank is not gonna go to work that day. It's over with. So you have to always think ahead and think smart. Like I was basically saying, let's get back to primaries. Now, people be like, man, bro, I don't have no credit and this and that. So I always tell them, start off with a primary. right? Step one, start off with a primary. What is a primary? A primary is basically just a site that can report on your credit every month. It's like a membership. So you might pay $100 to sign up and just pay. You can sign up for Self. That's an app. It's apps for primaries and it's actually sites for primaries. After you get the primaries, you want to try to go for a trade line once you're ready to make your move. So if you're ready to go get a car, if you're ready to go get a credit card, if you're ready to go get whatever it is, put the trade line on there. But I want to tell y'all, you definitely want to open up a banking account and get some cash flow going, and you actually want to get an account because you want to be able to show income. Because at the end of the day, everybody's going to ask you, how much do you make annually, right? Show them, like, look, this is how much I make, and this is my credit score, right? Because it just makes sense to banks is, okay, can he pay us back if we give him this loan? The credit card company, would he pay us back if we give him this credit card? So this girl, she asked me yesterday on FaceTime. I do like 20, 30 FaceTime calls a day. I be having more, but I just limit myself because it be real busy. You know what I'm saying? With everything else I got going on. So they are $150 and you can only purchase them through OnlyFans for right now until I create my next site. But long story short, she was asking me, she was like, well, you know, I got okay credit and I got two credit cards and I use both of the credit cards to pay my bills. And I tell her, like, credit is only used for emergency purposes only. If the creditors think that you need them, they will not increase your limit because they feel like you need them. The best way to finesse them is show them that I don't need you. Okay, they give you a $100,000 credit card, use under $10,000. Use around $4,000 of it. Okay, so that way, when you're on your Experian app, right, they're gonna be referring you to bigger and better credit cards because you are showing them that I don't need you. The payments that you're making back on that $3,000 to $4,000, it will make you look very, very good, right? And you can apply for more as long as you are increasing with your income as well, because you can't forget about your income. Just because we all know somebody might have an $800 but a $1,000 limit, I might have an $800 with a $400,000 limit. Two of the same limits, two different credit limits. Why? Because of the history. You might have an $800 and still cannot get an automobile. Why? Because cars have their own credit, right? Which means you go to a car lot, you don't have no car credit history. Yes, you can buy credit history if you're plugged in with somebody who sells primaries, auto primaries, right? But it get a little expensive and you really don't be supposed to doing that. So long story short, you go create your own car credit history. Go get a cheap Benz or whatever kind of foreign you want, pay it off for 6 months and work your way up. If it's 30, then they're gonna move you to 50 next time. Then they're gonna keep moving you up the ladder. You just have to move up the ladder. But now if you want a $100,000 car, you got the money to drop down and the paperwork to show that you can get it and your credit. Your credit doesn't mean anything if you don't have no car credit history. You can have an 840, right? And you never had purchased a car, right? If you never purchased a car, then they're gonna look at it like, okay, well, shit, you gotta start somewhere. So they're not gonna approve you unless you drop a crazy down payment, because they're not gonna trust you. So y'all gotta understand how everything works as far as like with this credit. It's not what you think, but it definitely will help you. About the banks scamming you. So banks make $1 billion to $1 trillion from overdraft, like trillions and trillions of dollars from overdraft fees. Now let me tell you how much is a scam. So do you know that banks have credit? Banks know that you need to build your credit. Banks know that it's hard times for people out here. So if you get messed up, this is how much they don't care about the poor. If you get messed up in life, you got $35 and you overdraft your account, right? Boom, let's say if you go negative $20 or whatever, but you hurry up and put it back in, they're gonna charge you $35 on top of that. Just because you went, depending on what bank it is, they're gonna charge you this crazy fee. And then the fee steady comes depending on how long you in. Then after that, this was crazy part. Instead of calling you, telling you like, hey, you know, you have an overdraft fee, you should pay it, or we can help you out, because you know, people are putting millions of dollars in banks, and I feel like banks should be the ones that helping people out as all the money that they're making off of people, correct? So you don't, let's say if you really messed up, like you didn't put no money in your account, you they're overdraft, you owed them $25, but they just made it an extra $100 and some dollars, right? These folks will close your account, put you in like, not put you in a check system, but they will put you in like a second chance type of system. This is why after you have a fallout with a bank, that's what I call it, it is hard to open up another bank because the banks noted in a system that, you know, this person is overdrive, meaning that they basically saying that you are a bad relationship. That is why when you go open up another account, they give you a second chance account. Why do I got a second chance account if I'm actually really struggling in life and I'm trying to get myself together? But because the banks know, they feel like if you are smart, successful, you would know more about the banks. You would know more about how important credit is. You will know never to go under what you're supposed to go under. They feel like a lot of poor people do that, and they try to keep a lot of poor people poor. They don't want you to have a banking account, right? Because banks actually help. Why? Because if you're smart enough to build your credit, if you're smart enough to know about credit history, if you're smart enough to keep income coming in, if you're smart enough to get an account, you're smart enough to get a loan, you're smart enough to get anything you want, and you're smart enough to get rich. They know that. So they don't want one of you 18-year-olds to wake up and like just get smart as hell, listening to Kevo and following what he's saying and actually blow up off of it and get rich as hell. It's tactics that they use. So you have to know these tactics. Why do people's accounts go negative so fast? Why is they making $1 trillion off of people that's just, you know, in the hood? Life works like this. They tell everybody, get a banking account, get a banking account, get a banking account, right? And every single bank has fees, right? It's a fee for this, it's a fee for that, it's a fee for this. Trillions of dollars are being made, right? But do they care about you if you get, if one day you might have $100 in your account and you damn near order $105 worth of food, and that $5 turned into $35, and then you didn't know, so you continue to working and not knowing, and you know, you saving up your money. Let's say you get paid in 2 weeks. So in 2 weeks, you look up your account negative $300. Now that's your whole check, right? Let's say your check $200. Your check $200, you still negative $100. Now these folks talking about closing your account. Now that direct deposit you had, now you getting checks, your account closed, you trying to open up another account, and they telling you, all, well, we can only offer you a second chance account. You looking crazy as hell, like what happened? And now guess what? That's on your credit. Yeah, it's on your credit. Now guess what? You need to know about Kevo's courses. You need to be on Kevo's OnlyFans trying to figure out how to get this off my credit. Because you don't know. Now you're trying to pay somebody. You gave them all your information. They taking all day. They stalling you out because they barely know what they're doing, but they know the proper ways to go about it, correct? But they really don't know what they're doing. Now they use your information for a lick that they homeboy told them about as a profile. You feel me? Come on now. So y'all should learn how to do everything yourself. Now, as far as let's go back to the banks. Okay. So when banks are in for business. Jails, all is crap. Colleges, they are not here to help you. They are here to make money. So understand, when you sign up for a bank, they are trying to make money off you. They're trying to push credit cards in your face. They're trying to push loans in your face. They're trying to push everything they can in your face to get that what? Interest. They're trying to get some money. So if you know that they're trying to get some money, you should know how to play the roles back. So people, bank, they finessing. Okay, well, with my credit, I'm going to do me some finessing. The finesse, the legal finesse is trade lines, primaries, and credit cleaning. That's legal. It's finessed out though, right? But a lot of African-American people don't really know about it. They don't know the game of the credit game. People are catching on, yes, but they still are lost in the sauce because they feel like, okay, cool, I'm going to add 2 trade lines and the primaries, and I'll be able to get anything I want. No, it don't work like that. You still have to know people. You might know somebody that have age primaries. You might know somebody who have auto primaries and stuff like that. But you have to know somebody. You have to have real money for that type of stuff. Build on everything. Your credit is your own person. You have to build that thing up and make it real strong and solid, because at the end of the day, you can make money off of having a good credit score. Like I told y'all, once you get your credit up, let's say if you got $100,000 credit card now, right? You can actually make money every month by selling your trade line, selling your authorized user to people. That's money, that's income. So this world pays you for being smart. This world pays you for having good credit, right? So just know, knowledge is the key to wealth, right? I'm giving y'all knowledge. I'm giving y'all stuff that a lot of people don't know about, and people are taking it and they're getting great results from it. They're like, damn, this really works. Stop buying all this liability, start buying assets. Also, I want y'all to know, spending money will always be more expensive than investing money. You feel me? So I know a lot of people be doing a lot of spending and doing this and that, but you should start having a mindset of being an investor. Because you know what scares you the most about being an investor is you're worried about the risk, but you're not thinking about the risk when you're going to buy this and buy that. That doesn't mean anything. Like, you have these guys out here doing I mean, designer is great to buy, but designer needs to be for a reason, for the better your brand, for the, is it a tax write-off? Is it in your business? Are you buying designer for no reason and it doesn't have anything to do with your business? You feel me? You got to think about that. Like, damn, am I? Like, or are you just buying a car just to ride around the hood to impress some people that don't really want to see you on, right? So you have to think about all that. I will buy a car for my business to help my business grow because people like nice things. I like nice things. You like nice things. You can't just say you don't like nice things. Everybody like nice things. Now, if you're negative and like, oh, I don't care about nice things, then you probably will never get nice things because you're so negative about it. You feel me? Structure yourself so that you can always win. Protect yourself at the end of the day from anything that can harm you. So, for instance, if you open up an LLC, you want to have your LLC separate from your name. So, my suggestion is open up an S corporation to divide your personal name from your business. This is your business. This is your personal name. That is my job, to be able to teach you guys that and basically get deep into depth. A lot of people do not know this type of stuff, and they be shocked when I know it because I know a whole lot of information. You want to know why a lot of people follow me and a lot of people rock with me? Because of what I've been through. I've been through struggle. I've been broke before. I've been lied on. You feel me? I've been the worst. The worst has happened to me, right? Sitting in a damn room for 3 years, right? So understand, if you are out here and you were out here while I was in jail, just understand, like, damn, this man's life was on pause and I was out here. What was I doing 3 years ago? You gotta ask yourself that. Was you really trying to get rich? I'm gonna tell you a lot of things with me. Like, the reason why I'm like this is because of God, right? When I was locked up, was praying at least 4 or 5 times a day, all day. Even now, even before I went in, I was praying a lot. So in order to get positivity, you have to put out positivity. You cannot be this big negative, hating, mad at the world person if you want to win. You definitely have to open up doors, open up opportunity. You know what I'm saying? You cannot run off all the opportunity. You cannot run off all the people who is meant to be in your life to help you. If you get what I'm saying. So, like, sit, look at your life and examine everything and know, like, damn, I gotta get to the next level today. Like, this week, I need to get up and go get this. Go make an LLC. Go make an S corporation. Get some net 30s on my LLC. Get some trade lines on my personal. Starting from somewhere will help you win, because starting from somewhere is better than starting from nowhere. Man, make sure y'all subscribe to my YouTube channel. Make sure y'all subscribe to my OnlyFans. I definitely have these courses dropping February 1st. Let me make a new video about what site I'm going to have my courses on, and also what site I'm going to transfer from OnlyFans, you know, because OnlyFans is, like, really a good site, you know what I'm saying? But I want to have my own site that y'all can get more deeper in depth with, you know, all the guys and getting one-on-one, and it makes it easier for one-click FaceTimes. Just a little bit more easier, because OnlyFans is strictly not for education, and I want to basically have something for y'all strictly for education, as well as my books that's coming. So I want to be the only person that's giving the most sauce, the most game that y'all can really take and really get help from, not just giving you some stuff that's just to, you know, pass by. No, I'm trying to give you something that can help you, man. I want to give you primaries, trade line sites that can really help you. I want to be able to give y'all advice on how to finesse this real estate game to the point where you can easily, with 10 bands, you can just go crazy, you know what I'm saying, and run it up off of strictly real estate. So that's my goal, man. You know what I mean? Follow me on OnlyFans at bandmankevo.com. Make sure y'all inbox me, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to be blessing you with a free guide. All my new subscribers, I'm going to be blessing y'all with a free guide. Just inbox me, you know what I'm saying, saying that you knew them. My OnlyFans, I'm gonna give you a free guide, man. Most of my guides would be like 200-300 pages straight info that you can really learn from. Bitcoin, all types of stuff on there. You hear me?
Yeah.